From tiny zebra mussels to huge Asian carp, the concern over invasive species continues to grow in North Dakota and Minnesota. Joining us with more on what you can do, Doug Lear with North Dakota Game and Fish. And I guess first, you know, people might not understand it, but why is there so much concern about about these species invading our waterways?
Because on a couple of different levels, number one, oftentimes these invasive species are exotic. They come from different places and they disrupt the food chain. They disrupt the normal natural cycle. So that's a real big biological concern. And then there can be concerns with the potential fallout from that of zebra mussels clogging up water intake supplies. And so there's a lot of different concerns that we have over invasive species, aquatic nuisance species, a lot of different terminology for them. And as you alluded to, they can be small to big, from tiny little zebra mussels to large Asian carp, silver carp, and that type of a thing. Well, the message that we really want to send is it's not just people that are boating or fishing or jet skiing or water skiing. It's everybody that spends time in the water and on the water. That's the main thing. It's not the other guy's issue to deal with. It's everybody's concern, and it's everybody's responsibility to do what they can to prevent the spread or the introduction of invasive species anywhere. Again, like you said, North Dakota, Minnesota, wherever.
And I know there are some really kind of key things that people on both sides of the river sort of encourage, require people to do when you're dealing with boats and things.
You know, that's a really good point, because we've transitioned over the last decade from things that were suggestions and requests of people to do it, and now it is the law. It is the law on a lot of these different issues. The generalization to adhere to the laws kind of follows three simple principles of inspect whatever is touching the water, whether it's the boat prop, the boat trailer, a jet ski, even in the fall time, decoys, anything that's touching the water, you want to inspect it. And then clean it, whatever's on there, from what you can commonly refer to as seaweed. Clean the stuff off. A lot of lakes areas have requirements as to what must be done if that water body has been infested with zebra mussels. And draining the live wells and the bilges, again, it's not a request. It's something that you have to do. And it's not once you get home. It's at the lake. It's at the body of water that you need to do all of this. And we can all work together to try to, you know, for the better of the cause, Kyle.
Little things we can all do to make a real big difference for our waterways, for sure.
Yep, we have to.
All right, Doug Lear, North Dakota Game and Fish. Thanks for coming in.
You're welcome.